गुड आफ्टरनून, मैं सेल्फ आशीष पोहने वर्किंग एज अ लेक्चरर इन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी एंड रिसर्च बडनेरा अमरावती। हियर टुडे आई एम इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट इज प्रोजेक्शन माइक्रोस्कोप बेस्ड ऑन बाय यूजिंग द स्लाइड ऑफ TS एज एन ओवरी। दैट स्लाइड आई एम यूजिंग हियर फॉर द प्रोजेक्शन माइक्रोस्कोप। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस माइक्रोस्कोप। That is here being as a parts. This is the screen that we can easily identify the slide, whatever the slide it is representing. On the broad screen, we can have the identification of TS of that particular sample or TS of that particular slide. Now here, these are the lenses are there. That is objective lenses. Then these are nose piece, then stage clips are there here, then aperture. This is the portion that it is called as an illuminator. Here it is a base of the projection microscope. Then here it is arm for the which will carry the or being as an handle to for carrying or handling purposes, that arm which is present here. Here a coarse adjustment as well as fine adjustment here also it is present. Then stage control is also present here. Stage by using that stage control we can have the control based on the stage. Then eyepiece tube is also present inside this part. As a part of introduction, this projection microscope from June 24, 2014, a compound light microscope with an added feature of projecting microscopic image to wall or a projecting screen is called projection microscope. So by using this projection microscope as a base, as a part of principle, is based on radial propagation of an electric beam from a point source. This is the point source that it is indicating through the illuminator. If you want to have a 1000x linear magnification of the image, a light flux per unit area of the object must be a 10^6x as intensive as per unit area of the screen. A light microscope with an added feature of the projecting the microscope image to a wall or projecting screen is called projection microscope. Here the projection microscope is interface with a computer to project the object on a wide computer screen for easy analysis. The projection microscope is very useful for classroom application as it projects the image to wall or computer screen. Projection microscope forms an extremely a large real image of some small objects on the distance screen, which can be computer screen. It is different from viewing microscope, in which the viewer observe a virtual image located in the same plane as object at a distance of 25 centimeter from the eye, the closest distance of the distinct vision. The objective lenses focus light from the object to create a magnified real intermediate image. The image obtained from objective lenses serve as an object or a source of light for the second lens. This second lens can be the eyepiece. The second lens can be the eyepiece in viewing microscope. Like that we can have the view for this by using this viewing microscope. A viewing microscope can be converted to a projecting microscope by increasing the separation of two lenses, named objective lenses and eyepiece. As the first principle, focus of the eyepiece lens lies to the right of image obtained from the objective piece in the projector, whereas second principal focus is to left of the image obtained from objective lens in the viewing microscope. In general, the projection microscope, the first lens of the microscope, the objective lens, creates a magnified real image of our object. This intermediate image serves as an object or base for the second lens of the microscope. The projector lens, through which the image project on the computer screen or screen which is available along with the projecting microscope. The use of this projection microscope, which is similar to previous compound microscope on this tour, then the light then pass through an objective lens is magnified. This is called as an objective lens, which whenever it is magnified, then instead of passing through an eyepiece, the image is magnified by projecting lens, which can be seen at the rightmost end of the device, and this image it is then projected on a screen. So this is the use of this projection microscope. Demonstration based on this principle, which we can use to have the apparatus called as a projection microscope. Thank you.